Hello everyone, myself Dhanashree Patil, and today I am going to give a lecture on pumping lemma for regular languages. First, before seeing the pumping lemma, we will see what is mean by a regular language and non-regular language. We have seen these concepts in the chapter of finite state automata machine. So, which languages are called as a regular language? The languages for which we can draw a finite state machine and also we can write a regular expression, those languages are called the regular language. And what is mean by a non-regular language? The languages for which we are unable to draw a finite state machine or we are unable to write a regular expression, those languages are called as a non-regular language. Also, we have seen what are the properties, benefits and limitations of finite state machine. We know that the given language is a non-regular language, but how we can prove or say that this language is a non-regular language? For that, the pumping lemma theorem is used. So the pumping lemma theorem helps to prove whether the given language is a non-regular language. So here it said that the pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not regular language, but we cannot use the pumping lemma for prove the language is a regular. If we want to prove the language is a regular, we can simply draw a finite state automata machine or we can write a regular expression. We are unable to draw a finite state machine and we are unable to write a regular expression, then we can say the language is a non-regular. But how we can prove that the language is a non-regular? So we are using the pumping lemma. Hence it is said that the pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is a not regular. Now here is the theorem of pumping lemma. First we will see what this theorem tells. If A is a regular language, the A language is a given and it is said that this language is a regular language. If the language A is a regular, then that language having a pumping length of P. How it is having a pumping length of P? Such that any string S which belongs to the language A, whose length is always greater than equal to the pumping length of P. If it is true, then we have to divide that string into three parts, that is into x, y and z part. After dividing that string into three parts, this string must have to follow these following three conditions. Means what? There is a one language A is given, that language is said to be a regular language. If the language is a regular language, then it having a pumping length of P, and a string from that language A whose length is always greater than equal to P, then we have to divide that string into three parts, that is into the x, y and z part, and after dividing this string into three parts, that string have to fulfill these three conditions at a time. Means if one condition is true, other two are false, it is not okay. At a time, all the three conditions should be fulfilled by that language. Then we can say the language is a regular. If one of the condition fails to fulfill, then we can say the given language is a non-regular language. So this is the theorem and these are the three conditions. The first condition is a what? X and Z part are kept as it is, and the Y part. Y part is a sub part of the string and this I is what raised to I, you can repeat Y as many times you want. Means the I is greater than equal to 0. Means the substring Y which we have considered, that we can repeat 1, 2, 3, 4 times as you want. By repeating Y many times, whatever the string we are getting, that string should be follow to the regular language. Means that generated new string must be a part of the regular language. This is the first condition. The next condition is what? What is the divided this Y part of the string? The length of the Y part is greater than 0. And the third condition is what? This X and Y together length of the XY should be always less than equal to what we have assumed the pumping length P. This is the theorem for the pumping lemma for regular language. Next we will see the steps to prove the given language is a non-regular language with the help of a pumping lemma. So the method which we are using to prove this, the method is used as a contradiction method. So first we will assume that this is a true, and at the end we will come to the conclusion whether this is a true or false. So the method is used as a contradiction. The first step is what? We are assuming that the given language A is a regular. The next step is a what? If the given language A is a regular, then we have seen in the pumping lemma theorem that the regular language having a pumping length, that regular language having a pumping length, and that pumping length is said to be a P. This is the second step. The third step, the all the strings which are generated from the given language, that can be a pumped up when the length of the string is greater than equal to what we have assumed the pumping length P. Now we can find out one of the string from that language whose length is greater than equal to the pumping length P. The next step is, once we have selected the string, we have to divide that string into three parts, that is the X, Y and Z. After dividing the string into three parts, we have to find out the first condition of the pumping lemma. What is the first condition? The X, Y raised to I, Z also belongs to the A. Means whatever the Y part, we are taking number of occurrences of that Y part only. Whatever the new strings you are getting, that string also belongs to the regular language. This is the first condition we have to check here, that if suppose X is A, Y is AB and Z is C, then YAB you have to take number of occurrences of AB. Suppose my I is 2, then my Y is AB, we will take that AB 2 times. So A, AB, AB, C. So X is A, C, Z is C and Y is AB. I have taken 2 times. So AB is repeated twice time. So the new string we are getting, that new generated string also belongs to the regular language A. If that is not belongs to the regular language A for the sum I, then we can say the given language is a non-regular language. The next step, you can divide the given string into three parts, that is X, Y, Z. So you can make any combinations possible. You can divide the string into X, Y, Z parts. So all the possible ways you can apply to divide the given string, yes. The next one is the show that none of these can satisfy all the three pumping conditions at the same time. Suppose first and second condition fulfills and it fails to fulfill the third condition, then we can say the given language is a non-regular language. Why? Because
we have to fulfill all the three conditions at a time. So all the three conditions are fulfilled at a time, then we can say the given language is a non-regular. If one of the is not fulfilling, then we can say it is a regular. So last step, if one of the condition fails to fulfill, then we cannot pump that string. That is a contradiction. Means what? First we have assumed that A is a regular, but it fails to first condition. So we come to the conclusion, the A language which we have considered as a regular, that language is a non-regular. So some of the examples or problems related to this topic we will see in next video. Thank you for watching the video.